Do you feel the boogie? This beta's fucking cancer. What is up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Deadshadows, aka Shadows, and we are back here today with the Celtic Heroes live open beta for the Astra Spring event, and we are about to jump right in and see all the new features that the beta has to offer. So without further ado, guys, let's get started. Now, I was in the closed beta, and there was a lot of bugs, so I'm pretty excited to see what they fixed and whatnot. I did list a couple bugs on the Celtic Heroes beta thread, and the admins did reply and said that they would take a look at them. So I'm curious to see what they changed. And immediately I get challenged to a duel. Okay, wow, there's actually a lot of people on, guys. If you look at that. Amulets on? Oh, I know a couple guys already. Sweet. Alright. Let's see. Oh no, this guy's gonna wreck me. I don't even have my main hand out yet. Alright, let's see. I don't have any of my rings hot barred. This guy's gonna wreck me. Oh yeah, here we go. Oh, he didn't even break my shield again. Now he did. Oh wow. Dang, we got a lot of people here. Amulet wants to trade. He's trading me instantly for. Let's see. Oh, he's giving me a wild boar. I already have this. Alrighty. Thanks, Amulet. So yeah. Other than that, let's see what they got. So you see now they show like trade complete and stuff. They did a lot of stuff. They updated. I guess the first thing I'll have to do is the chat bar. It's fully customizable now. You could literally change anything. You hit this, you make it bigger. Yeah, that's the zoom in. You make it bigger, wider, narrow. You know, you can increase how far it goes down on your screen. You could also drag it around your screen. So that's really neat. I love how they did that. That was awesome. I kind of like it small, personally. Leave it like that, that's fine. Alright, so, let's see. They changed how you... That's new, actually. That's fucking retarded. Why did they do that? Oh my god. I don't like that. Please change that OTN. I look like I'm an idiot looking in the sky. Like, I don't know where to go. I was gonna run into a tree or something. That's really stupid. And they didn't change how you, like, stand, your pose. He just looks up in the sky, like, why is my mage retarded right now? He's just gonna be running into the walls. Like, he doesn't even know where he's going. He's got his eyes closed. He's like, duh, just running everywhere. I hate that. Oh my god. So they added a lot of new animations for the mage. One that I really like is they made the books fly open. Like, he actually looks at the books now and reads them when he's attacking. That's freaking awesome. And they changed a couple of the cast animations. Most of this is like, the ice blast is the same, most of that's the same. I am pretty curious to see what they did change as far as... Okay, I don't have... Like, they added... I'm sorry, I'm jumping right ahead here. They added pets, guys. This is the coolest thing in Celtic Heroes yet. They added pets, and you need to feed them. Like, come on. It doesn't get more awesome than that. I need to I need to complete the first quest, though, to actually have it, and I need to feed it, I guess. And I'm sorry, I'm going on my horse. I can't deal with that running animation. I can't do it. I'll always be on my horse. I'm never gonna fucking run if that's how it is. It looks retarded. So let's start with the bounty vendor. So this is why I was saying save your bounty pledges. You can actually trade them for items now from the vendor. And it starts out, these are fashion items right here. And you start out with the basic bounty pledges, and then as you get more advanced, you can trade up, and like this one takes higher bounty pledges, and you get cooler armor though. You upgrade your fashion set, so it's really cool. You start with the basic, and then you could upgrade it all the way to what the guy's arming, the elite mercenary armor, and that's friggin' awesome. It looks really sick, as you can see, you know, the NPC is wearing it. So then we can go to supply shop, and you can actually buy freaking platinum items with bounty pledges now. This is awesome. This means that if you're farming pledges, you don't have to buy platinum to advance in the game now. You could just farm these pledges. It's awesome. I mean, they do cost 40 pledges for like a super combo, so it's a lot. Honestly, I think buying a super combo for 10k is less work, but it's still really cool, you know, if you don't have the gold and you have the pledges, or you don't have the money for platinum. So that's a really awesome thing. You could also trade it straight up for gold. So that's a whole new money system added to the game, pledges, bounty pledges. So another thing they changed is the stats menu. You have your XP, and you have your level right here, the gold, and then the platinum, normal. And you have your health, and below it, the sigils, and then your energy, and below that, the sigils. And then, one of the biggest thing they added that's pretty awesome is auto level up. And so you pick what you want your stats to go into, I think. I haven't tested this yet. But you pick what you want your stats to go into, and it automatically puts it right into your stats, so it's pretty cool. You don't have to worry about putting your points in where you're leveling. You could just straight up grind. Now let's go to your options. This is pretty cool one that I noticed. You have, I think all the chat options are basically the same. Text size and all that. But something really cool they added was the world time. So now when you're on the forums, if you have a bug or you want to send something to support, you could just put the time that the bug happened and it speeds up your support request a lot faster. So that was really neat. I love how they did that. All right, let's see. We're gonna go to the mounts. Let's see the new mounts, guys. So the Warthogs mounts is what they're called, I guess. So the Exalted Warthog staff. Let's test that out. We're gonna buy it and test it out. There's 1 mil on that. And then this one is 1.5 mil. This is actually, I don't know if they lowered it. They might have. Oh yeah, they lowered it way much. In the closed beta, this did 750 piercing damage per tick for 15 seconds. It was OP as fuck. Now it's 250. 750, I was like, yo, I could use that as my fucking main hand, dude. Like, for mages, that would be OP as fuck. But they lowered that. They nerfed the fuck out of that. Oh, look at that. I actually still have the boar from the old beta. Oh, no. Amulet triggered me the boar. What the heck am I thinking? So, yeah, this is the boar. It's kind of fun to ride, to be honest, guys. But, yeah, it's not something you see in your average Celtic Heroes day. Some dude just, you know, getting jiggy with it with a boar. That's pretty cool. I like Padman. They made Heroes Landing its own area. So let's go check it out, guys. I really like it. In the closed beta, it looked just beautiful. It was fantastic. I don't know if you guys noticed, but they did change a lot of, like, just effects and how the game looks itself. Like, it just looks a lot smoother. It runs a lot smoother. You could totally get 60 FPS consistently, even in the castle. So as you could see already, they added the pillars and stuff. And then right when you enter, it's just this beautiful land, and it's really neat. I like it a lot. They have ships out there. That's freaking sick. And then oh, it looks like I actually need to do the main story quest line. I believe that's how I unlock the pets. So we're gonna go find out. We're gonna do that, guys. The lighthouse keeper. She's not crying though. She is here. I need to get a torch. Okay, I already learned my shards. Thank you. Kill all these guys. Well, we got a lot of torches, didn't we, boys? Oh, now I need to go this way. I don't even need to go back to them. That's great.
Hey!
while we're waiting for this quest, I actually want to test out, I wonder if they fixed the cloud. I did make a thing about it, and they didn't fix it. It still just goes right into the ground. That's not cool, man. Wow, I was expecting them to fix that. I posted it in the forum, made a thread about it, and they just didn't fix it. Let's see, super grow, let's see if it makes your lag still. Gotta put on this growth chum. Yeah, it still makes you friggin' lag. Look at that, you just glitch through everything. Wow. Buggy as fuck.
We keep keep on partying till the night come. This ain't no fucking love song. This some smoke some weed, pop a bottle, do some fucking drugs song. We gon' party till the lights on. If they kick us out, then we keep on partying till the night come.
Guys, so that friggin' took forever. I finally finished the starting quests. And so now we can open up the pet boxes. So let's see what we get, I guess. I'm pretty sure I still need to get food for it. I don't really know how. I'm gonna find out how, but we'll figure that out in a second. So let's open up the pet box, and we found a tiny silver hound. Oh wow, they make you wait for it. So let's see this. No, not that. Okay. Oh wow, so that's pretty cool. As long as you feed it. So we need to get food for it. Okay, so we need to go to the paw. Now, this is apparently the pet shop. Okay, sweet. Oh, wow. Pet shop, ability trainers. Okay, well. Dogs. You could sell your dog. Huh, it gives you pet tokens. Oh, so you could level them up. That's friggin' sick.
Alright, guys, so we're back. And basically how the pet system works is you get these chests, and they will always give you a tiny brown dog or rabbit or some tiny animal. And then you could go into the... if this will turn... okay, that's a pretty big bug. So my screen's not turning for some reason. But you go to the pet vendor, you go to the dogs, if you have a dog or a rabbit, and you sell your dog for a token. And you get a token, and you come in here, and you have to go buy the dog you want. So say you want the tiny black hound, then you have to go buy the black hounds. And I'm trying to upgrade the tiny black hounds at the moment, but it starts with the tiny brown hound, which is the cheapest, and you have the tan one, the black one, and the silver one. And you buy these, and you simply trade up. Buy two of them. And then you come here, you buy them, and then you want to go to the breeder. And you go to the breeder, and you go to the black hound section, and you go to breed your hound. And then you need to upgrade it slowly like this. So like, this requires two small ones, and then that'll require two medium ones, two huge ones, and then that will require, the giant one will require two huge ones. So it's constant, just repeat cycle. I'm not gonna go through it over and over again because that's just gonna be really long and tedious, and that's something I do in my main for you guys. But I'm not gonna do that on here anymore for the time being. But I will show you the different ones. So I need to go feed this one now. The way the food works is come in here and you buy the food for your certain dog, and for a giant one it costs 1600, which is a lot, and it lasts for 20 minutes and it ends if you die. So that's kind of, I mean, I guess since it gives you like 180 vitality, that's understandable, but it does get expensive. They should increase the time in my opinion. So I use this, it feeds my dog. My dog comes to life, and you can see him. And, you know, obviously the higher level, the bigger their dog gets. So it's pretty neat system. Currently this dog, gives me like 60 vit or something? 50. So that's a pretty good boost, you know, especially if you have like the best one. It's going to be like a huge boost to your health. So it's pretty neat. That's cool, you know, to just have a pet running around. Even if you didn't have the biggest one, it's just really neat to have a pet, you know, following you. It's pretty neat. He was right through the wall. So that's pretty cool, guys. That's basically a wrap for this beta, apart from the chest. When the chests come out, I'm going to buy some and do an opening. So when this does go live, you're going to want to stay tuned for that, guys. I want to thank you guys for watching. It's been a fun review. This video should be up tonight. So I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Be sure to stay tuned for the chest opening coming when this event goes live. And apart from that, guys, peace. I'll see you guys next time.